Hi guys, my name is Kevion Miller, registered dietitian, and I will be showing you today how I make my homemade granola. So the very first thing you want to do is go ahead and preheat your oven to 450 degrees. Then what I do, I take out a small sheet pan, kind of like what you see here, and I go ahead and I line it with foil because I want easy cleanup. I don't want to have to clean this dish after I'm done making this. So when you line your pan with foil, that makes cleanup a lot easier. What we're starting with, 2 cups of old-fashioned oats. And I'm going to add to that about 2 tablespoons of ground flaxseed. Ground flaxseed is awesome because it's going to give you some omega-3s, which is really good for our heart. Also a really nice source of fiber. So it's nice when we can to kind of bulk up our recipe with a little extra nutrition and add some ground flaxseed to it. What I'm also going to add is 1 teaspoon of cinnamon. And I'm just kind of throwing in about 1/2 teaspoon of ginger, just because, just to give it a little extra spice. We also got a 1/2 cup of slivered almonds. Gonna go ahead and dump that in there. We're gonna mix all the dry ingredients together really well before we add in the wet ingredients. Okay, so just give that a couple of mixes. Now what we have is about 2 tablespoons of 100% pure maple syrup. The really nice thing about your maple syrup is a little bit really gives you a big bang in terms of the flavor of it. And then we have about 2 tablespoons extra light tasting olive oil. It's very important that it's the extra light tasting, because otherwise you're going to have granola that kind of tastes like olives. And we don't want that. So I'm going to mix this together. And what I may have to do is add just a little more maple syrup to this. So as you can kind of see, it kind of starts to clump together just a little bit. And that's okay. Just want to make sure this is coated really well. Okay, so I'm going to add a little more maple syrup. Just about 1 tablespoon more. Mix that together real good. Okay, perfect. So, what we're going to do next is just dump all of this on the sheet pan. Make sure we got it all in there. And I'm just going to kind of spread it, try to make a thin, even layer here, as thin as you can. Just kind of spread it all out. Okay, so that looks good. So now I'm going to stick this in the oven. I'm going to let it cook and toast up real nicely. It's probably only going to need to cook 10, maybe about 12 minutes. But you do want to watch it pretty closely so that you can make sure it doesn't burn. And usually what I try to do is put this on close to the top layer. And again, you just kind of want to watch it closely because it may not need to toast a full 10 minutes. All right, so after I cook this, I will share with you guys the finalized picture. So we're back. So the granola stayed in the oven for about 10 minutes, that's all. And look at how golden delicious it looks. This is, hold on, let me get some. So it is still hot. So when it comes out the oven, you just take your spatula and you just kind of scrape under it a little. Get it to break up and everything. And there you have homemade, yummy, delicious granola. Some good stuff, y'all. How's your house smelling nice and good with the cinnamon and the ginger if you choose to use that. You could even use like a pumpkin spice or a nutmeg. You can get super creative with this. But I hope you guys give it a try. It's really, really good. Nice source of fiber. So you can add about a quarter cup of this to your yogurt in the morning, along with some fruit. And then you have a really quick, easy breakfast on the go. All right. Thank you so much. Let me know if you have questions or comments below.